हेलो फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज डॉक्टर पवन जगन्नाथ तांबड़े वर्किंग एज असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन केमिस्ट्री एट मराठा विद्या प्रसारक समाज नाशिक। इन दिस वीडियो लेक्चर वी विल सी स्टीरियोकेमिस्ट्री ऑफ मल्टी सब्स्टिट्यूटेड साइक्लोहेक्सेन। डियर फ्रेंड्स, इन लास्ट वीडियो लेक्चर्स वी सॉ स्टीरियोकेमिस्ट्री ऑफ मोनो सब्स्टिट्यूटेड साइक्लोहेक्सेन। नाउ वी विल सी if more than one substituents are present on cyclohexane, then how that cyclohexane molecule behaves. We will try to find out the cis and trans isomerism in such cases and how we can assign the relative positions to group in cyclohexane in such cases. So for that, first of all, consider a disubstituted cyclohexane. In case of disubstituted cyclohexane, two atoms or group are present on cyclohexane. They may be similar or they may be dissimilar. For example, these four different possibilities are there in case of disubstituted cyclohexane. These X and Y, these may be atom or group and they may be same or different. So these X and Y may present on same carbon atom. So this is 1,1 disubstituted. They may present on neighboring carbon atom 1,2. They may present on relatively 1 and 3 position or 1 and 4 position. So these four different possibilities are there in case of disubstituted cyclohexane. And if you look at these four different possibilities, out of these four different possibilities, these three possibilities can give us geometrical isomers like cis and trans. However, in this case, cis and trans isomerism is not possible. So if substituents are present on 1,2, 1,3, and 1,4 carbon, then we can see geometrical isomerism in such disubstituted cyclohexane. And for example, in 1,2, these X and Y may be either on same side or they may be on opposite sides. So we can get cis isomer and trans isomer. In the same way, in 1,3 and 1,4, these X and Y, which may be same or different atoms or group, they may present either on same side or they may present on opposite side. And thus we can get either a cis isomer or trans isomer in case of 1,2, 1,3, and 1,4 disubstituted cyclohexane molecules. Now we will see cis-trans relationship in cyclohexane structure. For that, consider this is our cyclohexane molecule which do not have any substituent, and in this we can have these 12 carbon hydrogen bonds. Out of this 12 carbon hydrogen bond, 6 bonds are axial and 6 bonds are equatorial. The bond which are shown by pink color are axial bond, and the bond which are shown by black color are equatorial bonds. So in order to segregate this axial and equatorial bond, let's have a look at this structure. So in this structure, you can see 6 axial bond, which are further categorized into 2 types. Out of 6, 3 axial bonds are going up. So they are called as axial up bond. You can see the same bonds in this structure as well. 1, 2, 3. These 3 bonds are axial up bonds. And these 3 bonds are axial down bonds. 1, 2 and 3. So in the same way, we can have equatorial bonds. And out of these 6 equatorial bonds, 3 equatorial bonds are going up. So they are called as equatorial up, which are shown by green color. And remaining 3 equatorial bonds are going down. So they are called as equatorial down. So when we assign cis-trans relationship in cyclohexane molecules, then this is really very important aspect. Now, in order to make it further clear, I got this structure of cyclohexane. And if you look at this structure, this is similar to this structure. Only thing is, I elongated this bond on cyclohexane so that one can understand which bond is going upside and which bond is going downside. So if you look at these 6 bonds, for example, this blue 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. These 6 bonds are going up, out of which 3 bonds are axial and 3 bonds are equatorial, 1, 2, and 3. So they are going up. एंड इफ यू लुक एट दिस सिक्स दैट इज 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6, देन दिस सिक्स बॉन्ड्स आर कमिंग डाउनवर्ड्स. इन दिस सिक्स बॉन्ड थ्री आर एक्सियल बॉन्ड्स एंड रिमेनिंग थ्री आर इक्वेटोरियल बॉन्ड. सो इन दिस चेयर कन्फर्मेशन ऑफ साइक्लोहेक्सेन वी कैन फाइंड दैट आउट ऑफ 12 बॉन्ड्स सिक्स बॉन्ड्स आर गोइंग अप एंड सिक्स बॉन्ड्स आर कमिंग डाउन. एंड इन दोज सिक्स बॉन्ड थ्री बॉन्ड्स आर एक्सियल एंड थ्री बॉन्ड्स आर इक्वेटोरियल. सो दिस विल हेल्प अस टू असाइन सिस ट्रांस रिलेशनशिप इन मल्टी सब्स्टिट्यूटेड साइक्लोहेक्सेन मॉलिक्यूल्स. सो हाउ टू डू दैट? सो इफ एटम्स और ग्रुप ऑन डिफरेंट कार्बन आर मूविंग इन सेम डायरेक्शन दैट इज अपवर्ड डायरेक्शन और डाउनवर्ड डायरेक्शन, देन सच कन्फर्मेशन इज कॉल्ड एज सिस कन्फर्मेशन. आई रिपीट वन मोर टाइम, इफ एटम्स और ग्रुप ऑन डिफरेंट कार्बन एटम ऑन साइक्लोहेक्सेन रिंग आर मूविंग टूवर्ड्स सेम डायरेक्शन, मे बी अपवर्ड डायरेक्शन और डाउनवर्ड डायरेक्शन, देन सच एटम्स और ग्रुप आर हैविंग सिस रिलेशनशिप. हाउएवर इफ एटम्स और ग्रुप ऑन डिफरेंट कार्बन एटम ऑफ साइक्लोहेक्सेन आर मूविंग अवे फ्रॉम ईच अदर दैट इज इन डिफरेंट डायरेक्शन, से फॉर एग्जाम्पल वन इज गोइंग अपवर्ड एंड अदर इज गोइंग डाउनवर्ड, देन सच एटम्स और ग्रुप आर हैविंग ट्रांस रिलेशनशिप विद ईच अदर. So, if you understand this particular slide, I guess it is easy to assign cis trans relationship in multi substituted cyclohexane molecules. So, we knew that if axial position is occupied by atom or group other than hydrogen, it will show 1,3 diaxial interaction and that structure becomes unstable. This we saw in earlier lecture. So the more bulkier group always try to occupy equatorial position. When we write chair conformation, then always put bulkier group at equatorial position, and then you can put the remaining group accordingly to maintain the cis trans isomerism in that cyclohexane chair. This works in number of cases. There are some exceptions. In later video lectures, we will see certain exceptions in cis trans relationship in substituted cyclohexanes. So consider one example. Consider we are having this example in which two substituents are present on cyclohexane, out of which one is CH3 and other is deuterium. If you look at this structure, you can simply find that these two groups or atom and group are cis to each other. So first of all, find out which group or atom is bulkier. So in this case, CH3 is bulkier as compared to deuterium. So by default, put this CH3 on equatorial position so that we will get this type of structure. Now after putting this CH3 on equatorial position, find out relative position of deuterium. So deuterium is at second carbon. So it may be at this carbon or may be at this carbon. So I will put deuterium on this carbon. But when I put deuterium on this carbon, there are two possibilities. Either it will be on equatorial position or it may be on axial position. So I can get these two structures, deuterium on axial position and deuterium on equatorial position. Now we need to find out the relationship between these CH3 and deuterium. This CH3 and deuterium are cis to each other. And if you look at these two structures, then in this first structure, this CH3 is going downward and deuterium also going downward, that is same side. So they are cis to each other. However, if you look at this structure, then in this case, this CH3 is going downward and deuterium is going upward. So they are opposite to each other. So this is trans conformation or trans structure. So out of these two structures, this structure is the correct structure of this cyclohexane substituted molecule. So this is how we can draw the chair conformation of substituted cyclohexane. I repeat one more time. First, find out the substituent, find out which one is bulkier, and also note down their relationship, whether they are cis or trans. एंड यस डू फाइंड आउट देयर रिलेटिव पोजिशंस. देन पुट द मोस्ट बल्कीएस्ट ग्रुप एट द इक्वेटोरियल पोजिशन बाई डिफॉल्ट एंड देन पुट दिस सेकेंड एटम और ग्रुप ऑन रिलेटिव कार्बन एटम एंड फाइंड आउट द ज्योमेट्रिकल आइसोमेरिज्म. सो दिस इज हाउ वी कैन ड्रॉ द चेयर कन्फर्मेशन ऑफ मल्टी सब्स्टिट्यूटेड साइक्लोहेक्सेन मॉलिक्यूल्स. सो लेट अस सी अनदर एग्जाम्पल. इफ सपोज आई एम हैविंग दिस डाई सब्स्टिट्यूटेड साइक्लोहेक्सेन इन विच वन सब्स्टिट्यूएंट इज मिथाइल एंड अदर सब्स्टिट्यूएंट इज टर्शियरी ब्यूटाइल. सो आउट ऑफ दिस टू टर्शियरी ब्यूटाइल इज द बल्कियर वन. So these must go on equatorial position and the relative position of these two substituent is 1 and 3. If this tertiary butyl is present at carbon number 1, then methyl is present at 3, 1, 2 and 3, right? So first of all, put this tertiary butyl at equatorial position by default so that we will get this type of primary structure. Now, this methyl is at third position, so we can put methyl at third, that is 1, 2, 3, either on this carbon or 1, 2, 3, either on this carbon. So I am going to put it on this carbon. Now, when I put methyl on this carbon, there are two different possibilities. Either it will be at axial position or it may be at equatorial position. But out of these two structure, only one structure is correct. And for that, we need to find out the relative geometry of these two groups. These two groups are trans to each other. So if you look at this structure, in this structure, this tertiary butyl is going downward and methyl going upward. So they are having trans geometry, right? And if you look at this structure, then in this case, tertiary butyl going downward and methyl also going downward. So they are going on same side. So they are cis. So this is cis structure and this is trans structure. So this structure is correct for this molecule. Dear friends, don't get confused. In this example, if tertiary butyl and methyl are present on equatorial position, then this structure is more stable, no doubt. But this structure is cis structure. But we want to draw the trans structure of this molecule. So this is correct structure. Yes, if you consider stability of cis and trans, then obviously cis conformer or cis isomer is more stable as compared to trans. But here we are looking at how to draw the correct chair conformation of these multi-substituted molecules. So let us explore some more example to understand this concept. Now look at this molecule. In this molecule, methyl and C2H5 are present at 1 and 3 position and their relationship is cis relationship. In methyl and ethyl, obviously ethyl is bulkier, so this bulkier group we will keep on equatorial position so that we will get this type of say primary structure. Now methyl is at third position, so 1, 2, 3 on this carbon we can put methyl. In two different ways we can put methyl, either on axial position or on equatorial position, and thus we can get these two structures. But as I told earlier, out of these two structure only one is correct. Now we need to look at geometry of these two groups. These two groups are cis to each other. If you look at this structure, then ethyl is coming downward and methyl is going upward, so they are trans. And in this case, this ethyl and methyl both are coming downward, so this is cis. So among these two possibility, this is the correct structure of this molecule, right? In the same way, if you look at this 1,4 disubstituted cyclohexane in which one group is methyl and other is bromine, then we can draw the structure with same say steps. First of all, find out the bulkier atom or group. So in this case, methyl is bulkier one. So by default, put this bulkier substituent on equatorial position. So we will get this primary step. Now check out the relative position of Br. So it is at fourth number of carbon atom relatively. So 1, 2, 3, 4. So Br will be on this carbon. So again, there are two different possibilities. Either Br may go on equatorial or axial position, so we can get these two different structures. Now we need to find out geometry of these two group. These two groups are Br and CS3. They are cis to each other. And if you look at this structure, this CS3 group is coming down and Br is also coming down. So they are on same side. So this is cis. And in this case, this C2H5. Sorry. This must be CS3. It is coming downward and this is going upward. So they are opposite to each other. So this is incorrect structure. So among these two possibilities, this is the correct structure of this molecule in chair conformation. Sorry for this wrong group over here. Now we will see one more last example. How do we convert this molecule to its more stable chair form? Now look at this molecule. In this molecule, there are three different substituents present on cyclohexane, and they are at position say 1, 3 and 5. So first of all, find out the bulkiest substituent among these three. So simply we can note it. This tertiary butyl group is the bulkiest group. So first of all, put this bulkiest group at equatorial position. So we will get this first step. This bulkiest group at equatorial position, which will make this molecule a stable one. Then look at the geometry of this tertiary butyl and CS3 and deuterium. So if you think of tertiary butyl and methyl, they are trans to each other. So and if you look at relative positions, then tertiary butyl is suppose at carbon number 1, then methyl is at 3 and deuterium is at 5. So 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. These are the relative positions of these two groups which are shown by red color. Now we will put methyl trans to this tertiary butyl. So again look at the geometry of these two groups. Tertiary butyl and methyl are trans to each other. So they must be moving away from each other. So tertiary butyl is at this carbon going downward and methyl is at this carbon. It should go up so that there is a trans behavior in between two will get adjusted. In the same way, now look at the geometry between tertiary butyl and deuterium. Tertiary butyl and deuterium, they are cis to each other. And the position of this deuterium will be on this carbon atom. So deuterium may at axial position or it may be at equatorial position. If I put this deuterium at axial position, then deuterium and tertiary butyl will go away from each other. So it will become trans. However, if I put deuterium on this equatorial position, then it will come down and this is also coming down. So they are having cis behavior. So I will put this deuterium on equatorial position. So this is the structure of this molecule in chair form. Now once again, look at the geometries of these groups. This tertiary butyl and methyl, they are going away from each other. So they are trans to each other. So look at tertiary butyl and methyl. They are trans to each other. In the same way, look at tertiary butyl and deuterium. Both are coming downward. So they are cis to each other. Now look in our original structure. Tertiary butyl and deuterium, they are on same side. They are cis to each other. In the same way, you can look at this methyl group and deuterium. Methyl is going upward and deuterium is coming downward. So they are having trans relationship. So look at this methyl and deuterium. Methyl is projecting outward and this is projecting inward. So they are trans to each other. So this is the correct structure of this multi-substituted cyclohexane molecule in chair form. Dear friends, this concept is really very easy. Only thing is we need to do a little bit practice. I hope you understand how we can draw chair conformation of cyclohexane and substituted cyclohexane in this video lecture. Thank you very much for watching my video.